Hey, how are you this evening?
I'm good. How are you?
I'm doing all right. I'm under a charmed star because of tonight's scenario. Right up from the beginning of this, I want to thank you for doing, as you've done before, steadfast, heavy lifting to give us all the background information for our part two scenario tonight. So thank you for that. Thank you, man. Gentleman and a scholar.
Okay. You're welcome.
Well, hello and welcome to anybody watching this after the fact. This is scenario 311 from our Roman Civil Wars playthrough. This is part two of Utica, the Battle of Utica, aka the Valley. And I will not belabor everything. Peter did such a great job last week setting up all of the moving pieces of this. Suffice to say, we are the salient points here for those of you coming in late. We are in northern Africa. And these are Caesarian forces under Curio, and they are attempting to take on, in northern Africa, Pompey's general Varus, who has the support of King Juba and some of the Numidian cavalry as his allies. We saw they did a delaying action in the previous scenario, which was a very short affair. I'm not sure what that is for. It's really just kind of it says it could be played solo, but we did two very quick back-to-back plays of it, and that was neat. But tonight we actually get to the meat of the battle, and we are outside the city of Utica. So if you picture that the Utica is back sort of to the top right of this, perhaps that's even what that camp represents. But Varus and his forces are on one side of a valley, facing off and staring daggers at Caesar's forces under Curio on an opposite valley. Now, valley is a very, very general term here. In my research, I found that it's really just two rows of hills, only about 7 feet tall. So it's more of a depression than it is a valley. The only real, I guess, setup piece for this, other than, and I'm not even sure if you mentioned it last week, Peter, was that some of the political intrigue was that a few of Curio's men, the night before the battle, had skittered off and ran to Varus's lines, perhaps to get some food, and they informed Varus that Curio's men, on the whole, were not happy. They did not want to be in Africa in the first place. They thought it was probably a wasted effort. So Varus takes this and he tells his brother who was there, and his brother is a political figure. I believe they said he's a senator but he's definitely a man of some repute. And his brother's name is Sextus Quintilius Varus. And he comes out and makes a grand speech so that Curio's men can hear, saying that, yes, we hear that you are unhappy men, and you need to throw off the yoke of Caesar and come join us, because we have cookies, or whatever his incentive was. And so he spoke for quite a bit of time. We don't know if it was minutes or hours, but it was certainly probably a very eloquent speech. And he walks back to camp, and hoping to see this throng of people throwing down their forces and coming over and joining Varus to stand by Pompey. But as it turns out, Curio has a counter-argument saying, look, Caesar is your imperator, and you have sworn oath and fealty and allegiance to him, so you must do right by your general. And that seems to have quelled any of the grumbling and mumbling from those folks who had been unhappy with Curio's state of affairs. So he managed to suppress any of that perhaps tentative mutiny, and now we see that on the day of the battle, the two forces have lined up along these two hills, rows of hills, ridges, whatever they are. And we see over here we've got the Numidian cavalry under this unnamed general on Pompeian's left. And the way the battle played out is probably exactly as you would expect. Varus attempted to send some auxilia out first and see if he could probe a little bit. And those forces under Curio just came down off the hill and they mopped the floor. If I'm using a militaristic term. They mopped the floor with them. They pushed them up onto the hill, and at that point, the rout started, and it's just cascading. You know, it's like dominoes. They start falling, and once men start throwing down their forces, they started running back towards the city walls of Utica. In fact, so much so that it was causing a panic and a trample, and many men were trampled by their own forces as they were trying to get away from the feared Curio's forces coming after them. When all was said and done, Curio estimates his losses at probably about 100 men, and the Pompeian forces probably lost anywhere from 1,500 to 2,000 men between the initial attack that was repulsed and the crushing throngs that were routed back to the city of Utica. A failed attempt to make a stand by the Pompeian forces here, and Caesar's forces under Curio will eventually get up and start assailing the city directly. And that's really all there is to it tonight. So I'm going to turn it over to you for our war council and see what special surprises we have for us tonight.
All right, so tonight both sides are going to have five command cards. We're playing towards five banners, and the Pompeian side gets to move first. There's a little wrinkle here tonight. Both sides will be using the Julian rules, as we've been doing for these past few weeks. So that means our heavies and our mediums have a range one attack, and they can also elect to move two hexes and not fight if they so wish. There is a way to score some bonus banners here. If the Pompeian player, with his cavalry, travels down the length of the valley and exits in the two indicated hexes on the left-hand side, they will collect one banner for this show of bravery in the face of the Caesarian onslaught. If a Caesarian unit occupies the enemy camp, they will gain one victory banner. But if that unit moves off the camp or is eliminated, they will lose the banner. So they have to take and hold. So with that, the Pompeians get to move first. That will be Patrick. I'll command the Caesarians, and we have a fight on our hands.
We do.
So let's get to the main event.
Right. So I am drawing up some five cards here. I have my cards.
As do I.
And as always, good luck to you, sir.
And good luck to you.
I did not say I drew good cards, however. So we will, I guess we're gonna just have to try. All right, so we're gonna order our light troops. So that is up to five of them here. I think we'll do one, three, four, and five, because I have five. Oops, missed one. There we go. And now what to do with them? Let's see. Movement first. I did not expect this to be quite so taxing, we'll do one, two, three, and four. One, two, three, and four. And one to there. Okay, so that's all the movement. Let's do some shooting here. We'll have these light bow shoot at your light slingers. See if we can't do any damage. Come on, give me a flag. How about a flag? I like flags. So two dice. All right, nothing there. And these guys can throw some spears on their way. Let's throw it back here at this guy. So one spear. Hey, gets a hit.
Ooh.
And these guys will also do the same target. One spear. Nah, sadly, they are supported. And then these light bow will shoot at your auxilia on the hill. They did move, so they'll just get one die as well. And hey, there's that die roller I love. flush him off the hill. And that is all.
I'll activate two in the center. Being those two. All right. Cavalry will attempt to run down your brave Numidians.
All right.
Three dice with leader support.
And that.
Cut them down.
Cut them down indeed.
All right. But that being said, I'll advance, move one, and attack again.
Uh-oh.
Three dice.
Yeah, two. So two hits. All right, we'll go back with two. And nothing.
And the lights will attempt to follow, finish them off. Two dice themselves, with leader support.
Ah, well done. I think we'll do two in the center.
Oh no, my horsies!
Those two. These guys will go two and not battle. And they will go there and battle.
Oh, clever. Mm-hmm.
We'll attack your medium cavalry with five dice plus leader.
Can't evade now.
Nope. Oh. We get two hits. Here's the leader check. He's fine.
Come back at you with three dice.
Ooh.
Punishing.
These guys are not to be trifled with. What about your leader check?
Varus is fine.
Okay. There we go.
This can order some medium troops into action. Stupid light cavalry in the way.
Right. And whose fault is that?
Okay, we'll start here. So, attacking downhill with the mediums, capped at three dice.
Yes, it is.
With leader support.
Okay. Two hits. Two up the hill with leader support. And getting two hits. Bloody Valley.
Indeed. All right. These mediums will attempt to finish them off. Three dice downhill. Yep.
There you go.
All right. Four dice against a... Oh!
Yes. Varus was
cunning,
not fooled.
Varus.
Yes. Here is five dice plus leader. And we send a pack in.
Well done, Varus. Well done.
I feel like I should do this now. Since I only have one cavalry left, I'm going to order him into battle. He'll go one, two, three. And he will attack your lights. Now with four dice plus leader bonus. Two hits.
Oh, you go after the lights.
Yes.
Okay. Two dice back with clear bonus.
Okay.
Retreat.
I will take that retreat. And that is all.
do the smart thing, or I could do the dumb thing.
Oh, do the dumb thing, please.
All right, since you asked nicely, I'm going to counterattack, because I cannot let a mounted charge card go to waste.
You cannot. You cannot.
These are my weakest units right now. All right.
Evacuate in a moment of triumph. So you want to move that medium cav? Yeah, okay.
Not thinking this through. No, hold on.
Right. Okay.
Gotta choose my shots here.
Sure.
All right.
Yeah, they will
go out of those bowmen with four dice.
They will evade.
And they evade away. Okay. Going after Varus with three dice with leader support. Here we go. For all. See, I need this roll again. This is a good roll.
Well, yeah.
No. Got the roll I need for the other blocks.
That's right. Five dice coming back. Leader bonus. You got to hit.
So much for the shutout. All right.
Well, that's the way we're playing now. Okay.
Yeah, I know. I mean, let's face it, I've been humble these past few weeks. I need to get back to those winning ways.
That's right.
So, all right. Going after Varus again with the medium cavalry and this centurion. This now brings me up to four dice with leader support.
You got it.
There's your two. And for Varus, he's fine. Advance. Move one. Go after them. Just to check.
Yeah,
the entire turn. Yep. So four dice against those mediums.
Ooh.
Only one hit. But they must retreat.
This is tough. Well, I guess I just gotta do this then. Medium troops. It's gonna be this one, this one, this one.
You got another medium troop too over here?
Yeah, I do. I can't think of a really good way to move him, because he can't do too much. I guess he could come in here and throw a spear. These guys are going to go. Join Varus there. These guys will come up. Okay. So we'll try some spears first. These guys will do that. One spear at him. Nothing. And mediums against your medium cavalry with leader support. Now four dice. Ooh, flag city.
Brutal.
Okay, here's the check. He's fine. Okay. They will not advance.
Four dice and leader support. Ooh.
Ooh.
Ouch. One hit.
Okay. Four back with leader support. One hit. Here's leader check. He's fine. probably never going to get another chance to use this, so we'll activate these guys. Attack with 6 dice plus leader support.
That.
Here's the leader check. He's fine. And we will not advance.
I made not a critical error, but I did not make some range attacks when I could have last turn. Mm. Won't make that mistake this time. Right now, these mediums will attack your mediums with 4 dice and leader support. 1 hit. Send them on their way.
Say my name. I'm Spartacus.
That's not your name.
That is my name. It's a Pompeian name, clearly. All right, so we got 5 dice. Let's see what I get. Oh.
Nope, you gotta activate one of your mediums.
Practically a whiff. All right. So we are going to do this. He's going to go. I guess the best thing here is just to go after the cavalry. Since they can't evade away. So, let's see if we can't avenge some of our others. Brethren! With 4 dice plus leader. We got a hit and a retreat. 2 hits and a retreat. They go back 3. There you go. We will advance. Move 1. And attack down the hill at the auxilia. Now with 4 dice, three dice down the hill, plus 1 is 4 dice. So that worked out.
Well, and you're a mounted unit, so you're capped at 2 dice going down.
Oh, it is 2 down. So, yeah, it's 3. Thank you. So, 3 dice. Here we go. 2 hits.
Respectable.
And we will take that retreat. Okay. I might be Spartacus.
Might be Spartacus. All right. That's a real problem. Yeah. Well, I do this.
Interesting. Very interesting. Okay, let's do this. Let's do a coordinated attack.
Mm-hmm.
Do this. I'll activate. So we got 3 separate parts. Varus is moving on his own. He's going to go 1, 2, 3 to there.
That's sneaky Varus. Whoa! Sneaky Varus.
Yes. And then these guys are going to go 1, 2, 3 up the hill.
Sneaky horse.
And then these guys are just going to shoot it across the valley at your light slingers. 2 dice. Nothing. So these guys will attack your medium cavalry, or medium infantry, hill to hill. So for horses, it's 2 or 3.
You're still capped at 2, going hill to hill with a mounted unit.
Right. All right, so 2 plus leader bonus. Nothing.
And infantry unit will be capped at 3, goblin pack at ya. 1 and a retreat.
Hit. Leader check.
Ooh. But you can ignore the retreat as your leader still stands.
Yeah, we will hit and fade. All right.
Smart. Smart, 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 smart. Okay. Okay. 4 dice against those mediums.
There you go. We will use this card since I have no heavy troops anymore. And just have this unit attack your unit. 4 dice plus leader bonus.
Oh!
You gotta keep them separated. Alright, so that is all.
Couple of beans on that cavalry.
Beans.
Let's get 2 flags. I can do it. No, it doesn't matter. You got a leader. Ooh.
You wasted that shot.
Tired of being rained on. More retaliation. There you go.
Ow, you hit me in the head. Play a rally card. So we get 5 dice. What do I get? I get 2 mediums. So just the 2. So he will get 1. And he will get 1. And they will both activate. There we go. He's going to go back there. Because somebody's sneakier than me. Alright. So, these guys will just attempt to hit you up the hill here with 2 dice. And they do.
Well done.
Alright. I had to, when you said that, I had to look over and go, oh, hey, I won. Alright. Oh, boy, this one was a lot closer than I expected, because so many things to consider. I took the fool's gold and tried to move those cavalry, but I knew, as soon as you put a light cavalry in range up against something else, that was just death. I actually thought you were going to come at him with the mediums on the hill, just come down the hill and crush them, just press them right up against the other hill, but you use the cavalry, which is just as good, so...
Yeah, that's awfully tempting. We'll see. Depending on the cards I get, maybe I'll try it, maybe I won't. I certainly have a thought as to how it should be done. So if I try it, we'll see if that works.
Well, considering you've got 3 cavalry as the Pompeian, so that's 3 potential victory banners. So that's something that the Caesarian has to be guarded about. I mean, to be sure. So you got to get into that valley somehow and either block them or kill them or something, because you can't leave 3 banners on the table that easily. But yeah, no, this one's really intriguing. It's quite clever, actually. So let's take 5 minutes, and we will be right back after a quick water break. We are back with round number 2. We've reset the board. It is now Peter's turn to take the Pompeian forces. I will take Caesarea.
I gambled and lost in the first game and got foolish. Should not have done that. Should not have gone up those hills. On that side, at least.
I think it's very telling that you and I, you revealed your inner self saying, you want the shutout. My only goal is to keep it close because, you know, that's the kind of friend I am, right?
Wow. Really, really make me feel bad now, aren't you?
Man. All right. Let me draw my cards. Five. I have my five cards. Good luck.
Good luck to you as well. All right, Pompeians. How are we going to do this? Start ordering some light troops around. Those five. The bowmen will go after their natural enemy, the slingers. Two dice. Nothing. Same over here. And nothing.
Okay. I think I'll do three on the right. Those three, and we'll go
okay.
Right.
That's one way to do it, too.
Sure. And I'll have them move to that space. And they just get one die for moving, and they get nothing. So I am done. Well, maybe I'm still Spartacus. So.
Someone has an identity problem tonight.
I do. Five dice, let's see what I get. So it's going to be...
Not bad. Yeah. Not bad. Can work with that.
Yeah. So we'll do so two mediums, two lights. Let's start with the pelting here, down upon Varus. So, two dice for not moving.
Getting... Wouldn't it be three?
Oh, three, yes. So, got one hit. Here's one more die. Yes, it is three. So, one more die. So, just one hit. So, now the mediums next door, they have two dice onto Varus. And get another hit.
Hmm.
And another leader check. Wow. Close. Alright, and then we have the light slingers way over here going after your light bow with three dice. And we get one retreat. And then now the main event here. Light against your light bow, it'd be two up the hill normally, plus one for Spartacus, so three up the hill with leader bonus. What would they like to do? They will evade. Okay, so we're looking for green circles on three dice. We get one. Let's reshuffle, which I believe I failed to do last time. Thank you for putting that in the comments, I'm sure. Sorry!
I missed it too. I completely missed it.
Yeah, that's right. Okay.
It's a virtual deck, so it doesn't really matter. I mean, obviously, the only thing it does is it's keeping
the stuff that could come back out. Yeah.
Out of play again.
Right, right.
Okay. Curio. Old friend!
You ever dance with the devil in the
battle? Five dice with leader support. Gonna try and hit you before you hit me.
Two hits. Two hits.
Right, well, let's see what happens to Curio.
So, five dice in return with leader support.
Boo!
One hit!
Oh.
Two Ooh. Retreats! Well, we only have to take one. Maybe. Let's see what the leader check is like. He's fine, so he can go up that hill.
Hmm. Interesting.
I'm going to do four on the left.
Ooh. Ouch.
These. Okay. These guys will swing at Varus. One die. Pink!
How ignominious.
Duck, Varus! Duck! Alright, let's see what happens. Did we hit Varus himself? We do not. To the bowman. Okay. These, therefore, will attack your mediums here in direct combat with four dice plus leader bonus. Getting one hit.
Retreat.
Come up the hill. And these will get two dice up the hill plus leader support. Getting one hit. Okay. And that is all.
I like that card. I will do the same. One, two, three. Those four. Okay. Me, it's Varus. I'm back. Four dice going after Curio.
There we go. I got him.
Three dice coming downhill on those mediums. Two. And a retreat. So, Varus and his unit. I'll throw a spear uphill and not get lucky.
Two outflanked.
Outflanked!
Let's see, let's do these four right here. They will go there. Okay. All right. Let's do this one first. So three dice down the hill with a leader. getting a hit and a retreat. He will pursue down the hill. And he will attack Varus. Ah! Bait! You baited me! Yes.
Four dice with leader support.
Well done.
Curio lives!
Alright, so four back with leader support. Two hits.
Eight. I thought you were going for the sure thing.
No!
Okay.
Because I still got the other guy, so leader check. He's fine. And then this one. Is four dice also with leader support. There we go.
No, sir, I don't like that.
All right. Get your card. Oops, we're off a little bit there. Okay.
There, you go there. Auxilia going after Curio with three dice.
Bah! Oh! Could be 5-4, 5-4 tonight.
And freeing Varus up for the mediums. Varus lives! And,
The one thing I neglected to do in all of that was my medium cavalry attack on the lights, but I missed it, so that's my fault. I just moved him up there, I forgot to do it.
I mean, if you want to go ahead and do it, go ahead.
Okay. So, sidebar here. So, do medium cavalry here. Alright, here's three dice. Okay, so it's two hits.
All right, two dice coming back.
Oh. one, two, three, four, five, and six. Okay.
I'm sorry.
No, that's my fault. Okay, so good. Pot's right. Well done. How do you come back from this? Let's see what we can do here. Try to keep it close. All right. So let's do a coordinated attack. Do that, and that, and that. Okay. Start here with the light slingers on Varus. Two dice. Nothing. And we'll do the slingers down on this end on your medium cav. Two dice. Ooh, one retreat. And now for the coup de grace, I hope, here on this one. Three dice plus leader. And advance, move one hex, try to attack these guys. What would they like to do? They will evade. So three dice, looking for three green circles. Oh man, what a great evade. But sadly blocking the way now.
This is the way.
This is the way.
Four dice. Two.
Two. Hit, hit. Three back with leader. Oh, check the leader. Yep. Oh!
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 Unhorsed.
Unhorsed. Well done, sir. Man. Ah. Oh. I had it, Marcus. I was coming back. But as it stands, you take the series now, the final score for this. I got 5 in the first one. Peter got 4. Peter got 5 in this one for a total of 9. And I got 3, so by 1, 9-8. Good job. Man, this is a lot tighter than I thought.
It is. Because the run is tempting. And I thought I had the cards to make the attempt, and then you block the ends like you did.
I had a feeling. I had a feeling that
so, you know, I mean, obviously, I moved the horse here. So it's still 3 cards, because it's 1, 2, 3, 4.
Right.
You know, and then 1, 2, 3, 4, and you're still not off the board yet.
Right.
You're still there.
Yep.
So... It's a 3-card sprint, but I'm not sure that's really worth it.
I don't either. I thought about it 3 ways to Sunday, but I just never had the cards for it, other than just try to incrementally come up.
I just got the left card, and you know, and I was thinking about maybe trying to take these guys, those horses,
right,
and coming around over here and causing some trouble, but that is prone to backfiring, you know, with one flag and. Yeah. So,
there you go. There you go. Well, our final thoughts then tonight. What do we think of this as we now depart Utica for other pastures?
This one was interesting. It's a little bit of a puzzle. I think we've both concluded that the cavalry run is fool's gold. You know, so that's a matter of just who blinks first, who gets off the hill first, and. Yeah, you saw we turned the left side of that board into quite the bloody mess.
We did. I mean, both heavies went first. That is very surprising. It was just you said, "Hello, Curio, I'm here," and back and forth we went. You know, well, of course, Varus lost his heavies to rocks being pelted upon them from the other hill, but that was still one for the ages. I like it. I could see this one easily being a quick little... I always come back to the seeding scenarios for little tournaments. This might be one, because it seems pretty well balanced. We both had an opportunity to make some good strategic choices, and whether or not you ignore the running of the gauntlet. I think that's a wonderful mechanic for this one. It's neat because every now and again you get a scenario with just a little bit of a twist, and it's nice to see something out of the ordinary. So kudos, my hat is off to them for the running of the gauntlet from Utica, because it does play into the historical narrative. Well, we hope you've enjoyed this tonight. We're going to move on to 312. Well, you will be doing the research for that one, so it's almost like you did all the research for these.
Right. So, you know, as I alluded to, there are 2 major battles, Utica, which we just did, and then Bagradus River.
Right. Bagradus River. Right.
It will be next week.
Yes. Of Punic, first Punic War fame is the Bagradus River. So we're going to revisit those old battlegrounds where the bones of our ancestors have lied dusty in the desert along that river plain. So. We hope you've enjoyed it, and we will see you here next week. Take a moment to click the like and subscribe button, and click the little notification bell. And as you can see, we've got some supporters now, and if you feel like you would want your name up there on our weekly video for all future YouTube viewings, then you can certainly do that if you just click that little coffee link there, Ko-fi, and we certainly appreciate it. Do not feel obligated to in any way, shape, or form, but we are always happy to have that support. And that feedback section down there at the bottom in the comments, that is for you to let us know whatever we missed in our gameplay tonight. Luckily, we caught some. Peter and I are like, no, we forgot to do that. That Spartacus card is always a bedeviler. It always gets me because we're just so in the moment. We are certainly happy you're enjoying this, and we look forward to our next series. With that, I will turn it over to Peter. Any final thoughts?
Good night.
Good night. Have a good one. See you next time.